Howdy, just for fun, I thought it might be fun to do a kind of versus video. This is the Boss Super Overdrive SD-1 40th anniversary. I've already made a demo on it. It's a classic pedal. Everybody knows the Super Overdrive. Kind of the competitor to the Tube Screamer, I guess. It's been around a very long time, and it's highly favoured because it's great. The Axe-FX also offers a model of the Super Overdrive, which they call the Super OD. And what I've done today is set up kind of a matrix system so that I can put these two head-to-head to see how close the Axe-FX version is to the real thing. This, of course, is an Eastman SB59V. It's got some Lollar Imperial kind of PAFs in it. Beautiful. And the amp that I've chosen as a platform today is the classic British JTM45 with a couple of greenback cabs, and there's a little bit of reverb at the end. Now, how I've routed this, the guitar is going to the front input of the Axe-FX. The Axe-FX output number 3, which is echoing that input, is going to the Boss Super Overdrive. And it, as you can see, is on row 4. It's coming back in, and it's going to this thing called a multiplex, which basically routes whichever row or input that I want. So if I click scene 1, the Axe-FX SD is in the circuit, which is up here on row 2, because that's what's happening. The input's going up there to row 2, to the drive, and then back to this multiplex, which can switch rows. You see down here, it's switching between row 4 and row 2, okay? And that basically gives me completely isolated signal paths, but with the same input going to each. So if I go back to the Axe-FX scene, and you can see written up here that it says Axe-FX SD-1. I switch the second scene and it brings the Super Overdrive in. So I'll go back to the Axe-FX version and I'm going to turn it off for a moment, and I'm going to turn this off for a moment just so you can hear the bypass signal. Which is exactly the same in both scenes. Keep your eyes on this if you want to see which one is being engaged, but I'll try to convey it properly on the screen as well. Let's start off with them both with the three knobs, you know, set at noon, which is kind of the neutral position, I suppose you could say. So now the one thing to watch is that the drive on this guy is on the right. The drive on our Axe-FX model is over here on the left. So we've got drive, tone, and level over here. Okay, they're all at noon. Axe-FX. Boss. Neck pickup. Boss. Pretty damn close. All right, let's wind the level up to, say, 3 o'clock and the drive down to about 9 o'clock. We'll keep the tone in the middle, and we're going to do the same over here. So drive, what did I say, at 9 o'clock, tone in the middle, and level over here at about 3 o'clock. Here's the Axe-FX version. Boss. Neck pickup, Axe-FX. Axe-FX. right, let's try the volume wound down test. So we're on the Axe-FX, volume's at 3. Axe-FX slightly less volume, that's becoming apparent to me as we go along. The boss seems to have maybe another 1.5-2 dB of push. Okay, let's go the opposite way here. Let's go drive to 3 o'clock and level back to noon and tone at noon. So what did I say? Drive at 3 o'clock, level at noon, and tone at noon. Axe-FX, full volume on the guitar, bridge pickup. Boss. Pretty close. Full gain on the boss, full gain on the Axe-FX. Axe-FX. Neck pickup, Axe-FX. That's insanely close. Drive down at about 7 o'clock, full level. So we're really going to hit the front end of that Marshall quite hard. Full level. What did I say? Drive down to about 7 o'clock. There. Okay. Axe-FX. So there you go. Look, the Boss Super Overdrive is a great overdrive. Every home should have one, I think. The Axe-FX version is extraordinarily close to, probably, you know, close enough that anybody in the audience wouldn't be able to tell the difference. It feels the same under the fingers as well. The one advantage, or that there are several advantages of having it in the modelling on the Axe-FX, is that I can go down here and I can apply a graphic EQ to it, or I can actually alter all of its bass, middle, high, mids, treble frequencies, right? Let's do that. So I can really customize it quite intensely, and I've got this, what is it, 10-band graphic EQ, and also, if I want to, I can get dig right in and change the diode types, diode quantities, and then, you know, get into things like the slew rate, there's a bass response, lower the sample rate if I want to, alter the bias. That's a big lot of stuff that you couldn't possibly do in a hurry with the physical pedal. So they both have their advantages. The Boss Super Overdrive SD-1 is a classic. I love it. Hello, Yoshi. And the Axe-FX version is so damn close, it doesn't make any, you know, makes little or no difference. Just for fun. I think next time we'll do this again when I get a spare 10 minutes or so. We'll do the Metal Zone. Thanks for watching. See ya. That's the unmodified version. See ya.